everyone, how are you doing? My name is Estepario Siberiano and you are watching Sound Advice. On today's video, I am going to teach you how to play that. That would be what I consider to be my signature chop, and I've been using it for years, and I thought maybe this was a good time for me to teach or at least break it down for all of you so that you all can learn it and of course have a lot of fun playing it. That being said, this is a very simple chop if you break it down in two halves, so that's exactly what we are going to do. We are going to break it down on the first part and the second part, and then of course I'm going to give you all the stickings and we are going to practice both of them separately, and finally we will play all of it together at a very slow tempo, then at a medium tempo, and of course as always finally at a higher tempo. So the first thing we would have to do would be to grab the first part and learn how it goes. The first part of this chop consists on right, right, left, left, kick, kick, right, right. That's it. So both of our hands are going to be playing doubles. The right hand is going to be positioned on the floor tom. The left hand is going to be positioned on the snare. The dynamics are going to be mainly the same. Played at a very slow tempo, it would sound like this. We are going to play it on a loop so that you can learn it, memorize it, and of course, repeat it with me. Let's go with it. Un, dos, tres, y. Okay, so the first part of this chop starts with a left, a powerful one, a rim shot, followed by a kick, then another left on the snare, two rights on the floor tom, two lefts on the snare, and another kick. It may sound confusing, but once you play it for a while, it becomes very easy for you to play. It's easy to go with the flow with these kind of phrasings. The only important thing for you to consider in here is the fact that the second part starts with a powerful rim shot. And that change on the dynamics is the thing that really makes this chop powerful. So keep that in mind. And now let's practice the second part of this chop, starting very, very slow with me. Let's go with it. Okay, and now before we move on, we need to play both parts together. In order to do that, we are going to use the same tempo, a very, very slow one, and we are going to try our best to play parts 1 and 2 together at this speed. It's not going to be easy in the beginning, but you'll see, it's only practice. Let's go with it. Last one. That's it. Now, as you have seen, this chop ends with one bass drum, and that means whenever we are playing it on a groove, in order to keep playing whatever comes next, we will have to add another bass drum and play a cymbal. That's the only different thing that we are going to see whenever we are applying this on an actual groove. That being said, in order to make this more familiar to you, the next step would be to play it a little bit faster. So now let's see how parts 1 and 2 would sound together at a medium tempo. Let's go with it. Un, dos, tres, eh. Dos, tres, eh. 3 1 2 3 Okay, and now it's time for you to take your practice to the next level. Now we are going to try our best to play the whole chop, but this time a little bit faster. Actually, really fast. This would be the result after you have been practicing the medium tempo and the slow tempo for a while. Don't worry, for some it may be days, for some it may be hours, for some it may be months, but you'll get there. It's just a matter of practice. Let's go with this chop played at a high tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now the last step for you to practice this properly would be to play it on a loop, because it is a friendly kind of chop, so you don't really need to stop. You can just play it over and over and over again as many times as you want, and it's going to sound amazing. Let's go with this chop played on a loop again and again at this high tempo. Let's see how it would sound. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and that was the whole exercise. If you're able to play both parts separately, you will be able to play both parts together. Of course, you need to start slow, keep going until you find yourself comfortable at a medium tempo, and of course, finally, once you're an expert, you will be able to play the whole chop at a higher tempo, not only once, but also on a loop. So now I'm just going to do the same thing I did in the beginning. I'm going to play everything together at a higher tempo so that you can see how it sounds. Let's go with it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay guys, that was it, that was the breakdown. Of course, you got the stickings down there, it's only a matter of practice. From here, I wish you the best, I really hope that you had fun practicing this. Believe me, in the beginning it may look a little bit tough, but it's just a matter of practice. So practice and you will get there. And that being said, thank you so much for staying with me today. Stay safe and take care. Cheers guys, bye.